John, how many years is it since Jeremiah Wayne disappeared?
50. The 18th of last June.
Is it 50 years? It doesn't seem
Owen, that... Owen, I don't want to hear any more about Jeremiah Wayne or his son. The subject I finished with 50 years ago, and I don't want it reopened.
The subject may be reopened in spite of you, John.
What?
And after all, the boy is not responsible for what his father did.
What do you mean the subject may be reopened in spite of me? If you mean that good-for-nothing's making eyes at my niece, you're an old fool. It's absurd. Kathleen's known him only a few months. She knows I don't like him or his name.
Does she know why?
Whose idea was this game of dominoes anyway? Yours. And we sit down for a comfortable hour on a perfect afternoon, and then you begin dragging up things.
No, John.
Get this into your head, Owen. As far as this household's concerned, Kenneth Wayne might be dead and buried with his father in America for all that matters.
Oh, 50 years is a long time to hold a hatred, John. And if you could find it in your heart to be a little kindlier toward young Wayne...
He's the son of the man who's responsible for the greatest sorrow I ever felt, and you know it. In this very garden, 50 years ago, you were here. You saw her little white face, and you've seen me live on here for 50 years without Moon Yin.
Now, John...
No, don't say any more about it, John. I can't bear it. Good day.
What's ailing you at all, Dr. Owen? And you without a smile on the face that never lacked a smile for me before? Are you cross with me?
No, no, dear.
Oh, is it bad news? Oh, I know. It's about Kenneth. Oh, Doctor, dear, why does Uncle John hate him so? Sure, the lad never harmed him.
Well, I expect John will explain it sometime.
Well, I know this much. It has something to do with Ken's father and Uncle John's sweetheart, my Aunt Moon Yin. Years and years gone by. Oh, it's a queer world, surely. Somebody's always loving somebody they've no right to love. And as soon as they tell you you can't have somebody, that's the somebody you have to have, isn't it so? It's a blame nuisance, this love business.
Kathleen.
Well, it is.
Oh, I'm afraid I've done wrong to encourage you about young Wayne.
Oh, Doctor, dear, I needed no encouragement. Do you have to encourage the sun to shine? It just comes out and bathes us all in warmth and sweetness. And things just come to blossom in it. Well, listen to me. Who'd have thought I had that in me?
How about Ken Wayne?
Doctor, dear, I'm going to try to slip out tonight to meet him while you and Uncle John are at the Ainleys playing whist.
John is not going, my dear. He told me so.
Oh, why?
There's going to be a moon tonight, and you know what that means to your Uncle John.
Oh, yes.
Oh, Kathleen, I wish he'd get over this playing with the supernatural. Did you know that when there's a moon, he fancies he sees her?
His dead Moon Yin. Yes. Yes, it has me so. I've learned to dread a moonlight night. If you only knew what goes on in this garden sometimes...
What does he do?
Well, he sits there. And when the moonlight comes round to that gate, he holds out his arms and he calls to her, Moon Yin! Moon Yin!
Yes, and then?
I'm too terrified to look. I've tried often to get up my courage, but it's unearthly somehow.
Events follow in quick succession. Soon, Kenneth Wayne, young and handsome, appears and enters the garden through the gate. He speaks of love to Kathleen, and then tells her he's going away to war. Finally, he proposes to her. In the midst of it, Kathleen's uncle interrupts.
Will you be good enough to leave us, Mr. Wayne?
You've a perfect right to dismiss me, sir. Of course, it's your garden. I don't mean to be disrespectful, but surely Kathleen has some rights.
While Kathleen is under my roof, I choose her friends. Now, please understand, you're not welcome here.
Oh, Uncle John, dear, Kenneth will go. It's all my fault.
Sir, you've nursed a prejudice against me that has no foundation.
You are a Wayne. That's the foundation.
You're holding a grudge against me for some injustice my father did you. I don't pretend to know the facts, but I did know my father. Now I want the facts.
John Carteret refuses to explain to young Wayne, who defies him and leaves with a threat to marry Kathleen when he returns from the war. Kathleen begs John to explain his deep hatred of the Waynes.
My dear, 50 years ago, on the 18th of June, this old house was in a hubbub of excitement. It was a lovely summer night like this. The garden was in bloom, much as it is now. It was the night Moon Yin and I were to be married. As the long twilight faded into darkness, the old house was lit by 1,000 candles.
John, all day I've been trying to reconstruct my little world without you.
There'll be 3 of us, Owen, that's all.
John, I have something to tell you.
What is it?
I stopped in at the tavern on my way here. I've never been best man before.
Yes.
Jeremiah Wayne was there, drinking and talking about her.
A scoundrel.
I think you ought to be on your guard. He's not been asked to the wedding, of course.
Of course not.
Well, I'm wondering if that was wise. Well, I know how you feel. No man has the right to make threats just because he's refused by a woman. But Wayne's is a strange, bitter nature. At any rate, he was making some vague threats that there was still time and the wedding wasn't over yet and so on.
Owen, if it becomes necessary, I'll have to deal with him.
Mr. Wayne, you had no right to come here. Why can't you take your dismissal like a man? If you ever loved her, let her be married in peace.
If you'll take her that note and let me wait for an answer, I'll go quietly. If not...
I'll take it. Wait here. Have I your word of honor that you'll do as you say if I deliver this?
I'll go when I get an answer.
Ah, Jerry, it was nice of you to come round. I knew you'd never let me get married without wishing me well.
Moonin.
Oh, Jerry, Jerry, you mustn't begin this all over again.
I've as much to offer as he has. I was a fool to give you up without a fight. But it's not too late. You must come away with me now.
Jerry, Jerry.
Don't look at me like that. I love you. It's killing me. Moonin, I know I'm behaving like a crazy man. And that's what I am. Crazy. I shan't have you if I can prevent it.
How much do you love me, Jerry?
More than all the world. I can't give you up to him.
Do you know what you're going to do to prove your love for me? You're going to wish me joy and let me be married to the man I love because you love me.
I can't.
Look me straight in the eyes now and tell me that you want me to be happy.
I can bear it when I'm with you, Moonin. It's only when I'm alone.
When you're alone, say over and over to yourself, I'm doing it for her. Will you try?
I'll try. June roses and a June bride. Oh, my God.
Wish me well and mean it.
Jeremiah Wayne clasps Moonin in his arms, kisses her violently, and then rushes through the gate and disappears just as John Carteret enters.
Moonin! Moonin! Are you out here, Moonin?
Yes.
Who was with you, dear?
A message from someone who can't come to the wedding.
Oh, is there anyone in the world who can't come to the wedding? Oh, my darling, you look so beautiful in your wedding dress.
Oh, John.
Ah, tears. It's all been too much for you.
Hold me tight. I'm safe in your arms.
Love is all around you. Oh, you look too wonderful. When you turn around to me from under those vines with the silver light bathing you, you look like a little white ghost coming down on a moonbeam to greet me.
I'm no ghost, John. I'm real. But I love you till I am one and after.
Oh, my dear.
I ought to go in.
No, not yet. Let's pretend something.
What?
Let's pretend I haven't asked you to marry me, and let's do it all over again.
All in that case, how dare you have your arm around my waist? I know a better pretend.
What?
Let's pretend it's that beautiful day when first we met.
Oh, wasn't it beautiful? Do you realize I asked you to marry me that very day, and you said yes, and I didn't even know your name?
And I didn't know yours.
I said to myself, what a wonderful girl. Out of all the world, she's the one for me. I'm done for. What did you think?
I only know my eyes looked into yours, and I knew you were the one out of all the world for me. I was done for.
And with both of us thinking such wonderful thoughts, do you remember the foolish words we said?
Yes. It was just by the gate. I came in.
And you said, I beg your pardon, but does Jessica Wayne live here? And I said, no, she lives about a mile up the road.
And I said, oh dear, I've come from Ballyshannon to see her, and there was no one at the station to meet me.
And I said, I'm sorry to tell you, but I think Miss Wayne left for London yesterday.
And you said, it seems a pity not to rest a bit now you're here. Do have a glass of sherry wine, and I'll have my man drive you over when he comes back with the horses. And then we had the sherry wine.
And then I said, are you married or engaged? Or in love with anybody?
And I shook my head.
And I said, then you're going to marry me.
And I said, I might. And here we are.
And nothing shall ever part. Promise me.
Not even death itself. Because if I should die and leave you, John, I'd be so lonely for you, I'd come back to you. You'd never be without me for a single minute.
Oh, my love.
Jerry!
What do you want?
I said I'd go away, but I didn't. I've been out there all the time. Go into the house. I want to talk to him.
Jerry, you promised
me... Get away, will you?
Go in, Mooney.
I won't leave you.
Please, dear.
Not till I know what he wants.
If you've come to create a disturbance at the wedding...
There isn't going to be any wedding.
You behave like a madman ever since you discovered that Mooney cared more for me than she did for you. And I've been sorry for you. But if you try to cloud her happiness tonight, I'll settle with you afterwards. Now leave the place.
You'll settle with me now. I wasn't able to keep you from winning her. But by God, I can keep you from marrying her.
No, no!
Oh, Mooney!
It hurts here.
I never meant that. My God, I never meant that!
Send somebody after him. Head him off. He mustn't get away. I want Owen. Where's the doctor? Owen, come here!